Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. So in today's video, what we are going to be doing is diving into the awkward topic of Evernote versus Notion. Now, I have been not tearing my hair out, but actually sort of beating myself up recently about this sort of topic of Evernote and Notion. I have made a few tweets when I was like comparing it contextually to Evernote, and I think some people have sort of thought that I'm endorsing it as an Evernote competitor. And of course, functionally it could be, but right now I don't think it is. So I've done a full article on where I think Notion is at the moment, so you can read that one below, maybe get my sort of official thoughts on it. But in today's video, I thought it would be helpful, especially because I've been getting a lot of emails on this recently, to compare Evernote with Notion and sort of put them head to head in a note-taking context. So as a note taker, using them every day to take notes. I want to make that clear because I believe that Notion is more of a Trello competitor, a project management competitor versus a note taker. So what I want to do today is go over Evernote versus Notion, and in tomorrow's video, maybe the next day, depending on when I put it up, I want to put Trello versus Notion head to head. So hopefully you can get both of those sort of ideas around about it. So in today's video, we are going to dive into the head-to-head. We're going to talk about the features, the functions, and then give you general opinion as well by the end of this video. Now, just to be clear, I'm going to give you availability as well as information like that at the end. So if you want to skip ahead at any point, use the timestamps below. Now, I want to be clear about my own use of these applications. I use both Notion and Evernote together. I don't use them as a workflow necessarily, but they both assist me in my day-to-day routine about getting stuff done. Now, let's start with Evernote. Now, Evernote is obviously the market leader in note-taking experiences, and it's been around for quite a while now, guys. Obviously, we all know 10 years or so, and I've actually seen maybe the last 2 years, a lot of people opt out of the Evernote experience, mainly because things have gotten a little more complicated in terms of its design, and the design and features have gotten a bit static to some extent. But it still remains as one of the best note takers out on the market, and I think functionally it works fantastically. Now, you're probably new to Notion, and maybe even the opposite. You're probably like, Francesco, please shut up about this application. You've been going on about it too much. But Notion essentially markets itself as a workspace application, allowing users to do a whole host of things. They've actually mentioned on their website that they're a wiki, notes, and document application. Now, recently they released 2.0, which included a lot of new functionality, which I'm sure we'll talk about in this feature section, but it has been on many people's cards as an Evernote replacement and many other applications because the way that it structures itself in terms of being able to allow you to do pretty much anything. Now, just a note, I have actually personally used it as a note taker before, but only in light usage. So I'm going to explain how I use them nearer the end. Now, of course, Notion can be used as an Evernote replacement, but at the moment, Notion lacks the process that allows you to capture and take notes. So one of the things that Evernote does really, really well is the ability to actually capture the note and be able to process it into the relevant area. Now, of course, Notion has its, you know, pages function, but it doesn't really have the rigid structure that Evernote has in terms of notebooks and folders. So it makes it a lot more stricter when it comes to using Evernote. Now, the one thing I'd say is that Notion more compares to the likes of Dropbox Paper, Coda, Trello, than it does to Evernote, mainly because Evernote is more of a fixed note-taker experience and has all of the functions and features to actually get you doing that. It's quite hard to explain, but that's how I've gone about explaining it in certain emails to people. Now, let's start by talking about a few of the standout features of Evernote. So these are the ones that really do differentiate it from Notion. So first off is email into Evernote, and of course you can email into Evernote any of your notes or ideas, and this is limited in the free account but available in Plus and Premium, and does allow you to send emails in. That's a great capture method for people and something that many people do thoroughly enjoy, having that process in place. Now, Evernote has a host of scanning functions as well. So what you can do is you can scan in documents using a clear and very well working document scanner, as well as the post-it note scanner and a business card scanner too. That's if you're on the premium version. Now, Evernote standout functions as well has to be its availability on Android, as well as the web clipper as well. And also, Evernote does have more PDF functionality than the likes of Notion, allowing you to edit and modify and even capture elements inside of a PDF, which makes it a lot easier to use. Now, you're probably wondering, what are the standout features of Notion when it comes to being a note taker? And that would have to be the project elements. Inside of Notion, you could potentially make a note and add the items like, for example, a board or a calendar. Now, Evernote already has tables, but the actual action of adding a board or a calendar makes it so much more interactive. Now, within Notion, you now have reminders. Of course, you have this inside of Evernote, but the reminders are a bit more specific, allowing you to tag pages, people, and time and date, as well as getting reminded and specific reminders on all of those. And that's a very recent feature. Now, the layout is a lot more flexible, and you can add the ability to add backgrounds and iconography too. And I think the general structure of the way that the Notion is set up is that it is much more interactive. So in terms of price, you're probably wondering, how do these two compare? Now, inside of Notion's personal account, you can get it for $4 per month, and that's paid annually, or $5 ongoing. So Evernote actually priced themselves with Plus and Premium, and they're in the ranges of £35, I believe it is, and £50. But I'll make sure I'll add that in the description, because they always do change it. Now, of course, when it comes to value, the actual experience, if you're using it with a personal note taker, has to go to Notion, because Notion have no specific upload limit, and they have the flexibility to create whatever you want inside of that personal account. Now, in terms of a head-to-head editor experience, I would have to give this one to Evernote, because it's been around longer, it has really great functions, but in terms of fast catch-up, I'd have to give that to Notion. Now, Notion are hard to determine. They've obviously set three main goals sort of stuff in the next couple of weeks, so you've got to be watching out for this. They're releasing a web clipper, as well as an Android application and advanced commenting function. So of course, Notion is a challenger, but Evernote is putting up a fighting chance with their recent spaces function, and they are going, I feel like they're going to have a redesign, which will make a lot more Evernote users feel a bit more open. And this is mainly due to the experience getting very static, and I think with a more open experience, they can create a workspace that's more suitable for them. So guys, hopefully that gave you a nice overview of Notion versus Evernote. And of course, I'll be doing a video on Notion versus Trello after this one, so hopefully you can dive straight into that one. But anyway guys, I hope that you enjoyed this one. If you like these sort of videos, make sure to hit subscribe on this YouTube channel, and also join us for regular webinars and on the Facebook group too. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.